This video talks about Sallen-Key active filters. This is a simple topology used to implement second-order active filters. We see why you use active filters instead of the passive ones and the transfer function of this particular second-order low-pass filter. The problem with passive filters is that the load modifies the fundamental characteristics of the filter. The attenuation is larger than that without load because this number is always less than 1, and the cutoff frequency is shifted at higher frequencies. We could make the load much larger than the filter impedance, but we cannot go too far in this way, especially when we want a filter of high order. Other kind of passive filters use inductors, but in some applications this cannot be done because the inductors require two rooms. Moreover, the issue of the load affecting the filter is not addressed. So a filter like this is a poor one, because the second stage loads the first, worsening the attenuation and shifting forward the cutoff frequency. In order to decouple these two stages, we can use an active element such as an op-amp, which has a large input impedance and a low output impedance. This circuit is a second-order low-pass filter in which the second stage doesn't load the first one, just as the load does not affect the filter. In this case, we use the op-amps as buffers. The problem is that this circuit is expensive having two op-amps, so Sallen-Key topology comes to our aid. It is simple and it has just one op-amp. Here we see a Sallen-Key topology with amplification. The voltage on the op-amp input is V+, and it totally drops on RF resistor, generating the current V over RF. So Vout is VF plus the voltage drop on the K-1 times RF resistor. So the op-amp gain is K. You see, this is a second-order low-pass filter. Second-order because it has two reactive elements, and low-pass because you see this capacitor shunts the high frequency to ground. If a little high frequency signal appears on the output, then positive feedback takes it back, making it passing through the low-pass filter again. If a low frequency signal comes, it passes through the filter, then it is amplified by the op-amp. The low frequency cannot use the positive feedback with the second capacitor to go back, because at low frequency this is like an open circuit. So the low frequency at the output remains amplified of a K factor. So the low frequency passes and it is amplified, and the high frequency is shunted to ground, first directly and second through the positive feedback. It is simple and it takes just one op-amp for a second-order filter. Now let's derive the transfer function for this active filter. First, we take some reference voltages. We know already that V minus is equal to V plus, and V output is equal to V plus times K, the gain of the op-amp. Looking at the circuit, we can easily realize that this capacitor is in series with the resistor because no current enters into the op-amp. So the voltage Vx is divided between the capacitor and the resistor. So we can write this relation. Now we write the Kelvin current law in this point here. Through a little bit of algebra, we get this second order equation in which you see that the gain at zero frequency or in DC, so putting S equals zero, is K, as we explained before. This equation can be written in this form, dividing numerator and denominator by CR square. This form is more convenient because it's the standard form in which we can see the cutoff frequency and the quality factor Q. So the cutoff frequency is this and the quality factor is this one here. You see the quality factor is related to the gain, and changing the gain we change the quality factor Q. So the gain of the op-amp is an important parameter to set. But what is Q? Q is known as the quality factor of the filter. For too large Q, we will have some peaks at the cutoff frequency, and for low Q, the roll-off at the cutoff frequency will be greater and it will begin sooner. So it is not so true that the bus band of the filter is stable until the cutoff frequency. So we want a Q as high as possible, avoiding uttermost peaks. In our case, being Q 1 over 3 minus K, we want K at least 1, but no more than 3. At K equals 3 or more, Q is infinite or negative, and the circuit is not stable anymore. For Q less than 1, we have a quality factor less than 0.5, which is a poor one. making the gain of the filter going down much before than the cutoff frequency. The ideal filter lets pass the signal in some frequencies and completely stop the signal on the unwanted frequencies. But such filter is not practically achievable. Anyway, we can get closer to this ideal filter with some approximations. Here, there are two kinds of filters, the Butterworth and the Chebyshev. There are other kinds too, having a different frequency response. You see, the Butterworth is designed to have a frequency response as flat as possible in the passband, but the phase linearity is not good and the slope around the cutoff frequency is flatter, while the Chebyshev is steeper around the cutoff frequency, but it has some ripple in the passband and sometimes even in the stopband, so it depends on what you need. The designer, in the case of the Chebyshev type, is optimizing the roll-off at the expense of the passband ripple. With the Sallen-Key topology, you can design any kind of filter depending on the choice of the parameters, the resistor, the capacitor, and the gain of the op-amp. When you want to design a filter, you choose first the cutoff frequency and the quality factor you need for your system, and then you find the value of R, C, and the op-amp gain. Once defined the cutoff frequency, it's better first choosing the capacitor. As small as possible, keeping in mind it has to be much larger than the parasitic capacitance of your circuit. Then you choose the resistor. About the quality factor, if you want, for example, a Butterworth type of response to achieve flatness on the passband, the best value of Q is 0.07, so the gain has to be 1.586. Of course, you can cascade two Sallen-Key filters to have a four-order filter, and you have to choose the proper value of the gain for the first and second stage to have a Butterworth response. Here, an example. We want a second-order filter with a cutoff frequency of 159 kHz and a Butterworth response, so Q is 0.707 and K is 1.586. We choose capacitor of 1 nanofarad and we get resistor of 1 kOhms. RF can be chosen as we want, so we take RF 2 kOhm and RF times K minus 1 is 1.17 kOhms. The frequency response of this filter is this, where you see the cutoff frequencies at 159 kHz, the flatness of the passband, and the slope at 40 dB per decade in the stop band. If we need a steeper response around the corner frequency, we can require a Q of 5. In this case, the gain of the op-amp is 2.8. Since the cutoff frequency remains the same, R and C remain the same. The frequency response becomes this, where you see the peak at the corner frequency, which worsens the flatness at the passband, but improves the steepness around the corner frequency. Inverting the position of resistors and capacitors, we have a Sallen-Key high pass filter. You see, the high frequency passes unchanged through the capacitors and the signal is amplified by a factor K, while the low frequency is blocked by the capacitor and shunted to ground by the resistors. In any case, if a small signal low frequency passes through, the positive feedback puts it back and filters it again. A passband filter can be created cascading a high-pass filter and a low-pass filter, or with this topology here. Of course, this is a second-order filter and the previous one a fourth-order filter. Summing up, the Sallen-Key topology is a second-order active filter with just an op-amp and can be used to create various kinds of frequency response, for example Butterworth and Chebyshev, and any kind of filter, passband, low-pass, and high-pass. This kind of filter is widespread due to its simplicity and its ability to adapt to different circuit needs. Please leave me a comment, let me know if you liked this video. Make sure you put a thumb up, click the notification bell, and subscribe to my channel.